It's entertainment.
Let's feel this out for a minute, shall we? Let's feel it out for a minute. Wait a minute. Am I the only one sick of this beat? Let's switch it up for a sec, shall we? That's more like it.
Let it be known, nigga. Boss of all bosses, Machiavelli. Menace and methods label me a lethal weapon, making niggas die witness and breathless.
Part three.
Can you picture my specific plan?
Let's
be the man in this wicked land, underhanded.
I like this plan.
Scams and plot over grams of rock. Outlaws, motherfuckers die by the random shot. We all die in the end, so advance we swerve. I was all about my ears, fuck friends and foes.
It's been a couple days. I gave you guys the weekend. Did you digest it? Watch the party die, huh? I keep saying, man, Kendrick knows exactly what he's doing. Bravo! Bravo, Kendrick. Good one. You're right on time. I like it. The Super Bowl. People are going crazy. Saying Lil Wayne should have been the one picked. Let's talk about this just for a second. Do you guys really think the Super Bowl, the people in charge of the Super Bowl, give a flying fuck who performs at the Super Bowl, as in where they're from? No. They want what's hot, they want what the kids like, and they want what's gonna make people happy. You understand? Sure, when they go to certain cities, they might pick certain people for different reasons, and that's okay. But people are going crazy saying Weezy should have been the one picked for the Super Bowl. Listen, man, I'm not saying Lil Wayne doesn't deserve to headline the Super Bowl. We all know he does. A legend, a GOAT. But they went with the pick of one of the hottest artists right now. And Kendrick, right now, is on top of the world. And you can't blame him for picking what's hot. All they care about is money, the money. So they went with Kendrick, and people are saying, oh, but Drake turned it down. They didn't ask Drake to perform this year at the Super Bowl. Maybe they did in the past. People are saying he's turned down the Super Bowl 4 times. Making sure there's nothing in my teeth. Making sure they're nice and clean for you guys. I just had a steak. Drake supposedly turned down the Super Bowl 4 times. 4 times. Is it real? Is it not? I don't know. But I find it hard to believe that Drake would turn down the Super Bowl, yet alone once. But 4 times? You don't know what to believe, right? But would he? Do I think Drake would turn down the Super Bowl? Why the fuck not? He knows how those guys get in charge. Not only that, he knows who's in charge. Mr. Rockefeller, Mr. Jay-Z. Now we know the history of Jay-Z and Drake. Now would Jay-Z go as far to pick Kendrick Lamar to perform at the Super Bowl? Literally, he pushed Wayne to the side, because you gotta believe Wayne was in the discussion, right? To perform, it's New Orleans. It only makes sense. Would Jay-Z go as far to push Wayne to the side just to get at Drake? Hold on. I'm getting a phone call. Yep. You're damn right he would. You're damn right he would. Pettiness, man. Pettiness. The same way at the Super Bowl in California when he picked Dre to perform. And Dre said, I ain't doing it without them. Jay-Z had no problem with Eminem. And then Eminem said he wanted who? 50 Cent, right? And M said, listen, Dre, I love you and all, bro. But the way you got my back, I'm your artist. You put me on. I'm a part of your story. 50 Cent is a part of my story. And if 50 can't perform at the Super Bowl, Dre, then I'm sorry, brother, but I can't perform at the Super Bowl. And we know how much Jay-Z hates Mr. Curtis Jackson, right? Listen, man, I love Eminem for standing on business, for showing what true loyalty is all about, for showing what real brotherhood is all about. He told Dre, listen, man, I ain't doing it without 50. And Dre's like, I can't do it, Jay, without Eminem. So Jay-Z agreed. He agreed, but on one condition. It's like, okay, you want 50 there, M? You can bring him there, but I ain't giving him no time. You gotta give up one of your spots, one of your songs, the time you have for 50 Cent. You know what M said? No problem. No problem. I'll give 50 Cent one of my song times. It's all good. And we seen how that bitch was rocking when 50 came down, hanging upside down. They joked him. They clowned him. Exactly who he is and what he means to the culture. So Jay-Z, he obviously has a say. He has a pick in who performs at the Super Bowl. Well, he's part of that team behind the scenes, right? Did he pick Kendrick methodically? Was this a calculated move where he's like, how can I get at Drake? Because we know he hates Drake from the past, right? Drake didn't want to go on a streaming service. I don't know the entire history. I don't. All I know is something about Drake didn't want to go on his streaming platform or sign a deal with Tidal. I have no idea what it is. I have no idea what it is. But I know Drake and Jay-Z, they don't get along. And a lot of people want to go to that stupid little brunch, right? That stupid little brunch. Drake's like, I'll have my own brunch in my palace at home. I'm good. Good for Drake. Good for Drake. I love him. That was hard. That was hard, man. Listen. Kendrick is going to be performing. He had his little spot at the other Super Bowl with Dre and 50 and all of them. You know, he had his little minute or two, whatever it was. It was good. It was good. But to the new generation, right? It goes back to this whole big three thing, right? He's on top of the world right now. His numbers are crazy. The songs are doing numbers. But we know shit's being manipulated, right? We know how they get down behind the scenes over there at YouTube and over there at Apple Music, Mr. Ebro. We know that the numbers are manipulated. iPhone 5. I'm broke. And then Siri, for some reason, when you told it to play Family Matters or one of Drake's songs, it would play Not Like Us by Kendrick. Coincidence? I don't know, man. I don't know. But damn, is that funny? Good one, Kendrick. Good one. Kendrick's gonna be in front of the Super Bowl. Now, we know this is a PG show for the most part. Yes, have they had devils on? People worshiping the devil, right? We don't need to get into the symbolism and what they do and promote. But is the whole reason Kendrick is performing at the Super Bowl is so Jay-Z can take a nice little shot at Drake? In the background, of course, right? Always from the shadows, right, Mr. Rockefeller? Right, Mr. Sean Carter? Jay-Z thinks he's smart. And I don't think he's as smart as he thinks he is. I just think he knows the right people. As much as he wants to say he's a boss, oh, he's a boss, all right. but he knows when to be a soldier too, if you get my drift. Kendrick's gonna be in front of God knows how many thousand. And forget about the arena or the stadium. We know where the real money comes in. It's from all the eyeballs on the Super Bowl. The millions watching from home, right? All those advertisements. Millions for 30 seconds, 1 minute. Is Kendrick gonna perform? Not like us, 616 in LA, meet the Grams. I doubt it. I doubt it. But what he might perform is a cleaned up version of Not Like Us. Because I'm going to be surprised. I'll be surprised. If he gets on stage and Not Like Us starts playing, and then those lyrics, certified lover boy certified, I'd be surprised if the Super Bowl lets that fly. But at the same time, I wouldn't be so surprised now, would I? They've done weirder things, right? The whole song is a shot at Drake. The whole thing is going at Drizzy. The whole thing is made literally like, you want to put the coffin in Drake? Sorry, the nail in the coffin for Drake? That song is a good first step. Now, maybe the teenagers, right? The people that don't know what's really going on behind the scenes. Listen, man, I know I'm coming off as I'm fucking behind Drake. I'm not, man. Trust me. I'm not biased towards anybody, but I see what's going on. I see what's going on. Listen, is Drake perfect? Has Drake rubbed people the wrong way? Probably. But the way these guys are going 20v1, 20v1. Weekend's going at him. Future's going at him. Metro's going at him. Rick Ross is going at him. Kendrick. There's literally another 10 people. He wasn't joking when he said 20v1. I don't know what Drake did to piss all these guys off. From what I've seen, if I'm being straight up and real with you guys, we all know about that stimulus package, man. That care package from Drake when he hops on certain people's records, sends them right to the moon, right? Now it's up to them if they capitalize on it, if they know how to use the publicity they get from that to market themselves and make themselves bigger. We've seen people get the Drake care package, a nice little feature from Drake, and it plasters them everywhere, right? They go to the top, the numbers are there, but then they just fizzle out and don't know how to continue the momentum. So all I've seen from the last 20 years is, yeah, Drake being on top, all right. Drake gives everybody these little care packages, features on the song, makes them hot as hell, sends them to the moon. I see Drake always fucking with the youth. I see Drake always jumping on any feature, new trends, UK artists, Canadian artists. He does it all. I don't know why these guys are so mad at him. I know they say it's lonely at the top. Maybe he's done things in the background. Maybe he's done things behind the scenes when the doors are closed. Maybe he talks, maybe he says stuff. I don't know. I like to think Drake is a good guy. From what I see from him, from what he presents, I like to think he's a good guy. Doesn't seem like a prick. When I hear Drake talk in interviews, he seems like a smart kid. Seems like he got his head on his shoulders. It seems like he knows what he's doing. Now, could he be a grimy motherfucker behind the scenes? I don't know. Probably. To get to the point he's at, trust me, you don't get there by playing fair. You feel me? To get to that sort of position that Drake's at, you gotta step on a lot of people, if you know what I mean. And the way he's done it, if I'm being honest, he's done it smart. He's done it smart, dude. He's done it smart. All the features, he's on everybody's songs. All I see was good press of Drake for the last 10 years. Kendrick is like a ghost, right? Stop me when I'm lying. Kendrick's like a ghost. He comes and he goes as he pleases. Drops a record, drops an album. And just like that, poof, gone like the wind. I'd love to know. I'd love to be a bug on the wall to see what actually goes on behind the scenes. You don't gotta be a rocket scientist to know or to imagine. But how is Drake really? Now I know the little public image he paints for himself. He's smart, man. He's smart. Came up in Toronto. So just from that, the people he hangs out with, the city, I know how Toronto people are. I live right beside Toronto. I can literally blink and I'm there. I know how Canadians are compared to Americans. And a lot of Canadians are good-hearted people. At least I like to think. Same with Americans. But I can tell there's a big difference. I can tell that Canadians are good people. And I know. Just from the people he's grew up with, the people he hangs out with, his producer, the people he's formed friendships with, he's a good kid, bro. Drake's a good guy. At least I want to think he's a good guy. All this shit that they, you know, Kendrick's trying to bring up, the shit he did on stage with that girl. Listen, man, Drake was 21, 22, 23 years old. He was in between there. He was in his early 20s, having a show. Okay, we know 90% of his fan base is teenagers, little kids that love him. Okay? People are at his show. It's not like Drake was hanging out with that girl that he brought out on stage. It's not like he knew her prior to that moment, right? Somebody from his team picked her out, brought her on stage. Any girl's dream would come true. Going to their favorite artist's show and them picking her out, bringing her up on stage. What did he do? He didn't really do anything. What did he do to her? Grab her tits? What did he do? Start touching her? No, he didn't. The most, what, he hugged her, gave her a little peck. I don't even know. Don't quote me on that. I don't know what he did. Okay, he performed some song, and then it comes out after, oh, the girl was 16, 17 years old. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Are we gonna act now? And the people saying it are all the older people. It's none of the young people talking like this. It's all the people in their 30s, 40s, and 50s that when they were teenagers, I'm in my 30s. When I was a teenager at school, when I was 14, 15, 16, don't act like 30-year-olds, 40-year-olds weren't pulling up in the drop tops, picking up the 16-year-olds, the 13-year-olds. Everybody wants to act now like, ah! I see the hate train, man. The guy was in his early 20s, 21, 22. His team picks out a girl, brings her up on stage, and just because he said, oh, how old are you? And she goes, I'm 17. And then he goes, damn, why do you look like that? Are we gonna sit here and lie now? Like girls who aren't 17, 18, and 19 look like they're developed like a fucking 30-year-old? Are we gonna lie? Not to mention, Drake was probably drunk, right? He was probably on God, even if he was sober, whipty fucking do. The guy's in the moment, on stage. You're gonna hold the guy fucking accountable for every little thing he says? That's what you, one thing, he says one thing out of 5 hours, like they do on social media. People will have an hour or two long, conversation, and what do? They harp on the 5 seconds, the 10 seconds where they say something stupid that just comes out of their mouth because they're talking, and they harp on it, right? They want to use that. Look what he said. He spoke for 4 hours and 5 seconds. He said something stupid like we all do. How many of us talk just to talk? How many of us say things just being stupid? We just say it to say it. Now we're gonna get mad at this guy because he said, oh, why do you look like that? Be real, man. Be real. These guys want Drake out of here. And it's obvious, man. It's obvious. Drake, keep doing what you're doing, man. Kendrick, keep doing what you're doing, bro. It's working. We'll see what happens, man. The Super Bowl's gonna come quicker than y'all think. And up until then, let's see if we get more music. I know Drake said, you can drop 100 records, see you later. But I want him to cut for the love of the game, for the love of the sport. Doesn't get any worse from what Kendrick already said, right? Doesn't get any worse. If you guys think Drake's been sitting around for a couple months, doing nothing, believe me, he's not stupid. He's not stupid. I'd bet my life that Drake got already a few in the chamber. It's probably already cocked back. He's just waiting to... We'll see what happens, man. I hope all this stuff stays on wax. I hope all this stuff just... Let's keep it to the records, man. We don't want to lose Drake. We don't want to lose Kendrick. And all you stupid, crazy fans out there, just enjoy it, man. You don't need to hype up shit. You don't need to hype up shit, manipulate shit. Because we all know how the internet works, right? We all know how people get. I hope this ends peacefully, man. I do. What already happened at Drake's house was a shame. We'll get into that another day. Hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and hit that bell so you get all notifications. Follow me at Sidertainment on all socials for the latest and greatest. Subscribe to the second channel, Sid Clips, down in the description. I'm gonna start posting there. Subscribe to the TikTok, man. Subscribe to YouTube. We're gonna get back to it. Smash that like button.
Like we never left.
Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and hit that bell so you get all notifications. Listen, man, we're gonna get to it. Subscribe, and I'll catch you guys all in the next video, man. Until next time. Peace. Connected, respected, protected, OG. Fucking button, nigga, I can help with fucking monsters. Got me going crazy, motherfucking blessing choppers. You can't help me, no surrender to the doctor. I ain't going back up the image, but I'm a mobster. Broken dreams, sick things, and all this envy. Friends turn to peace, my heart is cold and it's empty. When I see you on my letter, respect for your bestie. Hope they got a physical clip and they just test me. Broken bones, nigga, I can help with fucking monsters. Got me going crazy, motherfucking blessing choppers.